Hey guys, Genius Corner here. In this video I want to show you how to make these interiors. First of all, I will show how to make this wall background for every kind of this, and after that we will make step by step one of them. So for the background number one, you can open it, then drag to the side and choose the program you need. Then you can slide it to the left, and here is the simple one. You just create box, rise it up, then you create plane for the ground, then with the E key and with the shift key you rotate and make copy, move it back like this, then move it to the side, go tools, array, here type in totals, then press preview. From the beginning you will have zero, so you need to rise it up in one of the sides. Then you will have from the beginning 10 count, you can increase them so they matches with the reference. Then you press OK. I will slightly move it down so I can select easy these boxes. Then I choose rotate tool, pressing E key, and then change pivot point center. For the default it will be use selection center, you need to choose use pivot point center. After that you will see this gray axis, and then you can rotate it like this. Without angle snap it will be much more smooth. So this is it for the first background. Next we have this kind of circle. To make this one, you need to make first of all cylinder or any other object as a reference, and here I will make radius 30 centimeters and height with 5 centimeters. Then I will copy it with the snaps, set it here and change the radius to 40. Then copy it again and make radius 50, again 60 and again 70. And the last one will be 80. You can make as much as you want, as you wish. I just count this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Next, I will create line. I just press Ctrl and the right key, so it doesn't need to go to the create, shapes. This is much faster. Then with the snaps toggle 2 and 5, I just go with my template and make this kind of shape. I will continue it here, then with the shift key make straight line here, here, and it's okay. I can press one key to activate these sub menus, and I will select vertex, and you need to have in the options enable axis constraints, so you can choose the axis and then snap it. Here maybe I can delete this part of spline so I doesn't need it, and I can press Alt Q to enter isolate mode. Then I will add lathe modifier. You need to press weld core, lately I will show why. Change align to minimum, here you can see some artifacts, weld core will solve them. Fine, then maybe for the default you will have 16 segments, so I change them to 64. Okay, and here is the advantage of using spline and modifiers modeling. You can always go back, choose this spline, this vertex, move them around, come back, and here you have changed form. Then if you want you can make it rectangle, but for this purpose you don't need to make. But in case you will need to have use this form in the interior, you can use modifier slice, choose remove top or remove bottom, for example remove bottom, then press one key on the keyboard and move it here. Then I press one key again to exit from the editing this slicing shape. I will copy this modifier and paste. Then I press one key again and change remove top like this. Then paste it again, press one key E for rotate and rotate it with the angle snap by 90 degrees and move it to the side like this. Then copy, paste, press one key, move it here and choose remove top, and you can place it like you want. Then you can add edit poly modifier, press 3 on the keyboard, select all these borders and press bridge, and now you have closed geometry. If you need you can remove this modifier on the line, change some values, then go back again, and here you need to change this align, for example minimum. And here you have changed your form. And for the slice modifiers you will need to make some adjustments. so that it doesn't slice the parts that you need. And here, as you can see, it very fast and non-destructive method. And then again, you just add edit poly and using bridge connect them, so I doesn't need them anymore. For the next, this kind of shape, it is the half of this full circle, just put it down and you can slice or doesn't slice, just use the plane for the floor and it will cover up the bottom part. Okay, next we have this arc, and to make this one I will also use the splines. So first of all I will create rectangle, then another one for the door or this kind of form. Then I will use arc and use snaps to create this shape, make it like this. Then you convert them all to editable spline with the right click, then go to modifier, attach them all together, press 2 on the keyboard, delete this and this element, then go to the 3 key and using trim this shape like that. Okay, then we have here 2 vertex. This is means that I have this kind of struggling. So to solve it, press 1 key, Ctrl A to select them all and press weld. Now it is one shape, and here we can use extrude modifier to make this kind of shape. Here you can see this ugly corner. To solve it, you need to go to editable spline, select this, and from here I will use fillet and make it smoother like this. Right click to disable this tool and go back again, and now we have this clear and smooth geometry. Next, you just create a box for this wall and for the back wall. This is it for these 4 types of wall background. Next, we will make render for one of them. Now let's create this composition. After I create background, I assign gray corona material on it. By pressing M, I open material editor, select corona MTL, drag and drop it like this, and then select all by pressing Ctrl A and assign material to selection. Now I can add chair to my scene. For those, I will just drag and drop it and select merge file. If this method doesn't work for you, you need to go file, import, and there find merge. Here I need just one click and I press Z on the keyboard to focus on the object. For some reason, this model doesn't appear in the middle of the scene, so I move it here. And we need to set up the camera so we can see what's going on. I will use Corona camera, place it, then press right click on the X axis so it appears in the middle of the scene. Then select here cameras, Corona camera. Press Shift plus F, and here you have these proportions. To set up them, you go to the render setup, press F10 on the keyboard, and here on the common I type in these numbers and press the lock so it keep the image aspect. Next, I select the camera and change focal length to 50 millimeters. Then I can here press dolly camera and by pressing middle mouse move it up and dolly again. Like this. Maybe it's okay, but I need to rotate the chair, place it like on the reference, something like this, rotate a little bit more. Okay, and from here I need to add lamp, and as you can see we are looking on the chair slightly from the bottom, so I can move it a little bit down, and to resolve the vertical issue I press automatic vertical tilt so this is doesn't appear. Okay, fine. Then I move target here, slide up it. Okay, then I merge the lamp model and I will rotate it, and also I want this wire be like this, so I will just mirror it. Okay, and then rotate. Then I will position it here, and I think it needs to be slightly larger. So I will scale it with the R key and second uniform scale, maybe like this, and then move it up. Here I will check it so it stands on the floor, like this. I use snaps by pressing S on the keyboard. And here we are. We have this kind of composition, and now we need to convert these materials because they made in V-Ray. So I start conversion with Corona Converter, and then using collect asset, I will find the folder where my textures are and then press C. So it found and the resolve path. Okay, and this one missing, I know what it is in the list asset. I doesn't have this texture, so I will delete this missing path. Fine, then I can start interactive render, and we doesn't see anything because we doesn't have any light in this scene. I will add corona light rectangle and make from here, then rotate it by 90 degree and place somewhere here. Start interactive render, and here we are. We get some lighting in this scene, and now I need to change this color so it matches. I will use this pick color function and find some color somewhere here so it doesn't have any changes from the light or shadow. Press OK, start directive render, and here what we get. Now I need to turn on the reflection and they're not so glossy. So I will decrease the glossy, maybe like this. Then I will decrease the saturation and maybe it can be slightly up the value. Okay, now we need to change color of the models. First of all, I will select this model, and I doesn't like to use materials that I get with the model because often they doesn't set up correctly in my opinion. So I will set up my material on this chair, then assign this texture. Using color correct, I will change the color. And for this purpose, I think that general tab and color correction from 3D Max will be comfortable in this case. I will change the hue shift like this and decrease the saturation. So now it have more similar color, and I need to turn on the reflection, decrease the glossy to maybe 85, so it's not so perfect. And here, as you can see, we maybe have more saturation, so I will turn it back. Okay, fine. Then I will use slightly this texture in the reflection glossiness, but I will decrease the reflection glossy amount of this map to 5%. Maybe it is will be enough. And next, we need to set up these reflections. As you can see, we have only on this side, and them doesn't appears very well. So I will move it slightly like this, and then rotate it. Maybe like that, and I want to make them not so big, so I will decrease this width radius, maybe slightly bigger like this. You can fine tune it as much as you wish. Then to get these reflections, I will just copy this white, rotate it, place it here. We get these reflections, and we need to decrease the intensity, maybe 2, so it doesn't destroy the shadows. Fine. Maybe I want to add more light, so I will change the intensity to maybe 100, and I will filmic highlights parameter change to 1, so we doesn't have any burnout pixels. Maybe intensity not so high, 80 will be enough. Nice, then we can work with this material, so I will select it. I will use move children, so I can move with this, disable move children and place it here. So this black color, I doesn't want it to be on this lamp. So I will change material map type to Corona MTL, delete these maps, and here I will assign the color from here, like that. Turn on the reflection, change the glossy, and as you can see, we have maybe it will be much more comfortable to activate 2D pen zoom mode and scroll here. Then I can assign this material also on this side like this, and maybe we can move this light up so the reflections is more interesting like this. And from here I think that I can change the reflection glossy for the chair, maybe something like this, so it doesn't appear so glossy, maybe 75, 76. And also I can slightly move it back or forward, and from here I will also rotate the light like this. Fine, now I doesn't have too much light here and the whole picture is much more interesting. Then I will disable 2D pen zoom mode to see my frame. And the last is this light. I will add it from here, just simple sphere like this, and place it in the right position from here. And in this window, I want it to slightly be visible to the camera. Start interactive like this. Now we can make it more intensive and add target. I can select this target. I will isolate it with Alt Q and select target, then move it here and move it down like this. And now I can make this light more intensive, something like 1000. So I get these shadows, maybe 1500 like this. Then I will reduce the bloom and glare. Glare intensity 01, and I doesn't like this kind of reflection on the chair, so I will try to exclude it by pressing exclude and on the chair. Now it appears more nice. And the last thing that we can do, we can change the color for this light, make it colder, and this one I will make more warm like this. And now we have something similar to this. We can add some vignette, maybe like this, slight filmic shadows, LUT, maybe not so much. I will use 5 of this and decrease the saturation to -0.5. Okay, change the contrast maybe to 1 and 5, and this is pretty enough. Then you can also enable sharpen and blurring, decrease the blur radius, and not so much for sharpening. Now it looks much better. And if you want to know why I use these parameters, why I use configurations for the Corona, you can check out my Patreon page. Here I explain what to do, and there I explain why I use this technique more in depth. If you have any questions, please ask me. Hope you find this video useful and see you next time. Bye.